Hey, so this is another update, now in week two. So halfway through the study trip, my technique has completely changed now. Last time I made a vlog, I was talking about using the first and second finger and thumb. And I did that for a while, and had to hold it so that it doesn't spin around. And that caused me to have a bit of pain and tension in my wrist just from squeezing too much. So I realised you can use all four fingers and thumb to maintain the grip and keep a really relaxed hand. It still doesn't spin around, and it means that there's no tension and therefore I can play a lot more relaxed. So last night I kind of had a bit of a breakthrough with playing for a dance class and being able to hold it like that so it doesn't spin around, it's the correct grip. My hands and wrists and shoulders are relaxed and can still play, or can play with speed now without getting tensed up, because previously when I played fast, I would get a lot of tension in my shoulders and then not be able to play properly. So it was something like this. So most of the exercises that we've been doing over the last week have moved on from that kind of thing that I said last time. We've been practicing octave doubles. And Sorry shows me this using his body language just to say that the arms should be like a set fixed distance apart. So this morning for about 20 minutes I just played this. Which is fine when it's quite slow. When it gets fast, start to tense up. So I need to work on just building the speed up so I can still be relaxed even when playing fast, when playing those octave doubles. So, yeah, it's definitely come on a lot. 2 weeks has been really good, and like I said, my technique has completely changed. And playing quite a bit of stuff that uses quite big spaces, like big gaps, big movements with one arm. So that's just an example of just the left hand part of one accompaniment that I've been playing. But I feel like I used to try and get there really quick, and Sorry's just said how you can just take it slow, you still arrive at the same time. Another example, or another thing he's pointed out, is to not try and rush little fiddly bits like this, just keeping it really relaxed. And so one accompaniment that we've been doing, Ginny Farry, has a bit of both in, so I'm just going to play that and show how it's come on. Fast doubles like this, you can sort of loosen your third and fourth finger and your first finger, and so it kind of bounces between the two ends of your hand. What else did I want to mention? Yeah, like I said, with him using his body language, because of the language barrier, it's a bit difficult to get things explained. But he keeps just sort of going like that to just say that you have to be relaxed and just kind of glide across the instrument. So yeah, that's been the first 2 weeks. It's definitely making me realise that a month just isn't enough. Anyway, that's that.